Hello,
I'm Penny Lazarus. I am a piano teacher and I study voice. And my selection of a poem for this year's virtual favorite poem project that is always organized annually by Debbie Szabo is a poem by Elinor Wylie called Velvet Shoes. A little bit of backstory as to why I chose this poem is this year in my piano studio, I've been encouraging all of my students to study compositions by women, underrepresented women in our work. And because I was doing that in a piano studio, I figured I might as well do that in my own piano work and in my vocal studies. And so I ordered a book called Women Composers, A Heritage of Song for Low Voice, because I'm a mezzo slash alto one, along with Debbie in the Newburyport Choral Society. And in that collection, I discovered a composer who I've just fallen in love with, Mary Howe. Mary Howe lived from 1882 to 1964, and her work should be well known today. When she was composing in the middle of the 20th century, her work was very well known. She was very good friends with Amy Beach, who made a successful career as a woman in music composition. And the two of them set up the Society of Women Composers, a first for the United States. So it's through this poem that I discovered Elinor Wylie's work. Elinor Wylie was a suffragette. She grew up in Washington, D.C. Her father and grandfather were both politicians. Even though she started to publish poetry in 1921, she lived a very free life of sexual mores for the time. She had several marriages and affairs. She lived in Europe. She lived in London, back into the United States. Her first published set of poetry, from which Velvet Shoes comes from, was called Nets to Catch the Wind, published in 1921. And Velvet Shoes, the poem set by Mary Howe, what became a favorite from the entire collection, and perhaps one of her now most remembered pieces. So I'm going to read Velvet Shoes, but then I'm going to comment a little bit about how this piece has been picked up by several composers for voice. So it has this continued life in history if we're looking at underrepresented composers. Velvet Shoes. Let us walk in the white snow in a soundless space, with footsteps quiet and slow at a tranquil pace, under veils of white lace. I shall go shod in silk and you in wool, white as a white cow's milk, more beautiful than the breast of a gull. We shall walk through the still town in a windless peace. We shall step upon white down under silver fleece, upon softer than these. We shall walk in velvet shoes wherever we go. Silence will fall like dews on white silence below. We shall walk in the snow. So Mary Howe was not the first composer to find Elinor Wylie's words. It was, as far as I know, Randall Thompson who set this poem, Velvet Shoes, in 1938. But when Randall Thompson did so, and you can look this up online, and it's probably the most famous rendition of this poem in song, he set it as a wedding march. And you could recognize the rhythms of both Mendelssohn's wedding march and the wedding march by Wagner in his opera Lohengrin. It has that same da-da-da-da-da-da wedding march rhythm. And in fact, at the end of Randall Thompson's version of Velvet Shoes, in the piano part or choral part, he quotes a bit of the wedding march from these composers. When Mary Howe set this poetry 10 years later in 1948, in the middle of women composers trying to get to be recognized for their professional work, she doesn't choose the wedding theme at all. And in fact, she emphasizes the walking in the woods rather than the idea of a couple to be married. And in order to represent the footsteps of walking in white snow, she uses alternating time signatures of 5-8, 4-8, 3-8, and 2-8. So, and it's really remarkable for that. And it's a very beautiful song that should be produced much more often. So I don't know the entire history of all the composers who have set this song, this poem to music, but I did discover yet another one. And that's because I continued to study composers of color who are underrepresented in all of our music work. And in a anthology of Black composers, I stumbled upon the same poem by Hal Smith in 1955. He said it as part of a work that kind of represents the four seasons called Valley Wind. And this, of course, represents winter. He sets the piece the most delicately of all three composers. And the first performers of his velvet shoes were women of color. And it's remarkable to think about the color of one's skin against the white snow and the breast of a gull and a white cow's milk and the white lace and the white silence that is throughout the poem. So thank you very much for listening, and I hope everybody will want to explore a little bit more of poet Elinor Wylie and the settings of her poem by Randall Thompson, Mary Howe, and Hale Smith. Thank you.